eyes and don't try to hide.
For a silly spook, they sit by your side.
Shrouded in a dark disguise.
They pretend to terrorize. When we ghosts come out to socialize.
Moon climbs high on the dead oak tree.
Spooks arrive for the midnight spree.
Creepy creeps with eerie eyes.
Start to shriek
and harmonize. Then we ghosts come out to socialize.
The first appearances of the Haunted Mansion at Disneyland date back to 1951, 4 years before the park itself even opened, when Walt Disney and his then much smaller team of Imagineers were planning out the areas near Main Street, USA. Disney legend and then Imagineer Harper Goff created a black and white sketch of a crooked street that would lead away from Main Street to a rundown manor on a hill overlooking Disneyland, along with a peaceful graveyard and church. Walt Disney was fond of this idea and summoned Disney Imagineer Ken Anderson to write a story using the sketch. Some of the ideas that came of it were tales of a sea captain ghost that killed his wife after discovering his life secrets, and then hung himself out of guilt. Wow, that's pretty dark. As well as a mansion home to an unfortunate family, along with a ghostly wedding party featuring well-known Disney villains. Though these ideas weren't directly used in the final product, many of them were still implemented to an extent. Walt Disney did not like the idea of having a run-down building in the middle of the park, taking away from the beauty of Disneyland, and instead opted for a nice-looking mansion with a haunted interior. Disney is actually famous for saying, "We'll take care of the outside and let the ghosts take care of the inside." More sketches would come later on, with inspirations drawn from the Evergreen House in Baltimore, Maryland, and later the Winchester Mystery House in San Jose, California. In 1961, 6 years after the park's opening, flyers were handed out at Disneyland's entrance announcing a 1963 opening of the Haunted Mansion. Construction then began a year later, and the exterior facade was finished in 1963. The ride itself would not open until 1969, however, due to Walt Disney and his Imagineers putting the Disneyland projects on hold to work on the 1964 World's Fair, and after that, a reimagining of the attraction itself. The original plan was to have a walkthrough attraction within the mansion itself, and after the 1964 World's Fair had passed, this idea had evolved into the Museum of the Weird, which would be a walkthrough attraction with a restaurant inside of it, similarly to the Blue Bayou restaurant in the Pirates of the Caribbean ride. Originally created from the ideas of Disney Imagineer Raleigh Crump, this Museum of the Weird, as the name inferred, would be more of a bizarre horror attraction, including items like talking chairs, a living gypsy wagon, busts that would follow guests as they walked by, candlemen, coffin clocks, etc. The ideas would continue to evolve when Disney Imagineers Mark Davis and Claude Coates had conflicting viewpoints on the attraction, with Claude Coates wanting a darker, scarier adventure with items like endless hallways and long corridors of doors, and Mark Davis suggesting a sillier, more lighthearted horror attraction with more gags. Davis and Coates would eventually both get their way when Imagineer Atencio combined their ideas, creating an attraction that would begin in a creepy, dark environment, transitioning into the sillier, gag-filled side. It was also around this time that Atencio, as well as Buddy Baker, created the attraction's theme song, Grim Grinning Ghosts. Fun little fact, the bass singer in this song is Thrul Ravenscroft, the same voice actor and singer who sang You're a Mean One, Mr. Grinch.
You're a mean one, Mr. Grinch.
Shrouded in a dark disguise.
As well as the original voice of Tony the Tiger in the Frosted Flakes commercials, among other things, and the voice of a few of the other attractions at Disneyland. Imagineers Yale Gracie and Raleigh Crump were put in charge of creating the illusions for the attraction, many of which would end up being used in the final product, such as the ballroom dining table scene with all the transparent ghosts. By the way, those ghosts are not projections. They instead use the Pepper's Ghost illusion, a technique that's been in use since the early 19th century, wherein a physical figure is placed below the stage out of the audience's sight and a bright light is shined up at it, reflecting the figure onto a pane of glass onto the main stage. In the ballroom scene on the Haunted Mansion today, you'll probably notice that there's a massive pane of glass in front of everything, and that would be exactly why. Following the death of Walt Disney in 1966, the Museum of the Weird idea was abandoned, as the Imagineers objected to the low capacity that would come with a walkthrough attraction. Some Imagineers even suggested building two identical attractions to accommodate twice as many guests. However, this was around the time that the Adventure Through Inner Space attraction had opened in Tomorrowland, which utilized the high-capacity Omnimover system, wherein a chain of vehicles holding 1 to 3 guests would traverse the ride, never having to come to a stop because of its slow speed. Another plus of this system was how the cars could easily be rotated in any direction during any point in the ride, so the Imagineers could control what guests could see and hear. The attraction would eventually open to the public on August 12, 1969, and was an immediate success, attracting record crowds. That's right, ladies and gentlemen, they teased this attraction for 8 years. Similar versions of the ride would also eventually open in other Disney parks around the world. The first came to Walt Disney World in 1971, then Tokyo Disneyland in 1983, Disneyland Paris in 1992, and Hong Kong Disneyland in 2013. Since its debut in 1969, very few changes have been made to Disneyland's Haunted Mansion. The first major changes came in 1994 in the attic scene, when a sinister-sounding mix of the Grim Grinning Ghosts was changed to a sinister mix of Richard Wagner's Bridal March, before going back to Grim Grinning Ghosts in the next scene. More changes to the attic scene came in 2006, when the creepy ghost bride with the big heart was changed to the villainous Constance Hatchaway, the lady who marries rich dudes and kills them. The ride has also undergone various refurbishments, making minor changes to the lighting and projection systems, as well as the safety spiel. Also, the Halloween overlay with characters from the Nightmare Before Christmas was added in the mid-90s. And that pretty much completes a brief history of the Haunted Mansion attraction at Disneyland. Other than that, that's all I've got for you guys today. So if you enjoyed this video, it would be absolutely amazing if you could like this video and subscribe to the channel. With that being said, I hope you guys enjoyed. I am the Space Mountaineer, and hopefully I will see you in the next video.